how Universal let this happen, but James Wan is now solidly in the Warner Brothers business. I mean, we're talking about a director who's red hot right now off of a Universal picture. Furious 7 not only joined the Billion Dollar Club, but has dominated it, and any day now it's going to surpass The Avengers to become the third highest grossing film of all time. That means it goes James Cameron with Avatar and Titanic, and then James Wan. And Universal had the right in his contract to exercise their option to have him direct Furious 8. And I think that's what we've been waiting on. And I guess they're not ready. Maybe they want to go back to Justin Lin. Maybe they want to take the franchise in a different direction. It's very tricky after what happened with Paul Walker, tragically. Maybe James Wan, who handled that beautifully, feels he's burnt out on that and he just wants to move on. And he does have a very good relationship with Warner Brothers. And I guess Universal doesn't want to hold him hostage. But still, what a loss. I guess it's kind of like revenge from Warner Brothers because Universal got Legendary and to some degree I guess Christopher Nolan, because he has a very strong relationship with Legendary. So they're like, haha, we take James Wan. And what are they going to do with James Wan? Well, listen to this. He's not only going to direct Aquaman, we all expected he would go on a DC property, especially because of his strong relationship with Warner Brothers from the Conjuring films. Well, they're going to be films. He's made just one for Warner Brothers, but Warner Brothers was able to woo him back to the horror genre, even though he is kind of keen on leaving. But I guess part of it is because they were like, James Wan, let's build a relationship together. We take care of our people. We let Ben Affleck be Batman. We want to keep people who are at Warner Brothers happy. And I think that Warner Brothers, perhaps more aggressively than any other studio, is really trying to keep its in-house, create an in-house talent pool that they reward with choice projects. So he's got an Aquaman, which he's going to direct, and also the Robotech movie. And Robotech is like this anime show, which has been in the US as well. And it's kind of like Transformers meets Pacific Rim meets like Edge of Tomorrow, which sounds pretty good. So especially when you know that James Wan is going to be at the helm. I am a huge James Wan fan. And what I think he did with Furious 7 was masterful. I think that's a very well-directed movie. I know some people like to write it off, especially because they're upset that it's surpassing their favorite movies on the all-time list at the box office as only doing well because of what happened to Paul Walker, which I do think added to interest in the film. But I think that it wouldn't have worked if James Wan, A, hadn't done such a great job, as I said, handling that very delicate issue. And then also B, made a great movie. I mean, it's just a really fun movie. Furious 7 is very good, and the action sequences are handled quite well. So I'm very excited for James Wan, because I've been rooting for him for a while now. Big fan of the guy. And so I'm also happy because it's going to make these movies really good. And I think that's what we're going to focus on for the rest of this video, and that's, of course, Aquaman. Who would have ever thought, you know, when they first said, oh, we want to make an Aquaman movie. And Geoff Johns, by the way, did a wonderful job tackling all the jokes that are made about Aquaman when he relaunched the character in the New 52. I mean, that was really well done as well. But who would have ever guessed when we said, we're going to make an Aquaman movie, that Aquaman would look like this, played by Jason Momoa, and it would be directed by James Wan, which kind of guarantees this is going to be an awesome movie. I think Jason Momoa is still a little bit of a wild card in terms of his acting ability, but I think if he's used correctly, like he was in Game of Thrones, I think he can be a strength. And I think that James Wan is a savvy enough filmmaker to use Jason Momoa correctly. So, and boy, did Jason Momoa luck out here or what? I mean, first he gets this really kick-ass costume that looks fantastic, and then he gets James Wan, probably the hottest director in Hollywood right now, to handle his movie. So I think that Jason Momoa is probably doing a little dance, you know, of happiness, because this is going to be just so amazing. Is James Wan doing a dance of happiness? I don't think so, because I think he's now under tremendous pressure to deliver. I mean, he's delivered pretty much consistently so far. I think maybe one or two missteps in his career. And I think that he needs to deliver again. And he has a bar set incredibly high by himself with Furious 7. And Aquaman is a bit of a hurdle. It's a difficult subject matter. You know, you have the sea versus earth. Watch any Aquaman property, be it read the comic, watch one of the animated movies. It's really tricky, especially the underwater sequences. It's a difficult thing to do. And I don't think that anyone has really gotten Aquaman right. Geoff Johns did a good job, you know, tackling the jokes made about the character. But I think that, you know, it lost its way when he got his own superhero team, the others. I was like, what am I reading? This isn't Aquaman. So we'll see. We'll also see if they're going to have Amira in the movie. That'll be a major casting decision as well. We'll see who they go with there. But I think this is very exciting for Warner Brothers. They just got done having a headline today about how they're getting masterful filmmakers to take over their DC properties and to then tell their versions of the characters and tell great stories that just happen to feature superheroes. And what a way to accentuate that idea, right? And be like, this is what we're going to do, and here's an example of it. And for those of you who are saying James Wan isn't a masterful filmmaker, I disagree. He might not be the kind of masterful filmmaker that you like to think of when you think of such a talent, but he's really good. He's really good at action. He's good visually. And I think one of his strengths is that he's really good at story. He's a very good storyteller. He understands the importance of having a good story to a movie. And I think that Aquaman, if it can have a good story and amazing visuals, and if they can kind of pull back Jason Momoa to just be this imposing figure like he was on Game of Thrones, you could have something that's really special. So the DC positivity train keeps on rolling, and it seems they've really turned things around. I'm very curious to see how the balance of power in the superhero movie market is disrupted when DC finally gets a foothold properly in the marketplace. All right, so I'm very curious to what you think. Do you think Universal was crazy to let James Wan go? Do you feel a lot better about Aquaman now? Or do you think James Wan has made a horrible mistake? And how about that Robotech movie? Are you excited about that as well? But just look at James Wan's future. All for Warner Brothers, by the way. The Conjuring 2, Aquaman, Robotech. What a slate. And he's producing movies as well on the side. So he's being very prolific, and he's going to become, I think, one of the major names in Hollywood. So exciting. And I guess finally, what do you think of Warner Brothers building a stable of talent and giving them such choice properties to make sure they keep them involved? Even J.K. Rowling was given the scripting duties on Fantastic Beasts to get that movie greenlit. So Kevin Tsujihara is not above cutting a deal to keep you in play. All right, thank you so much for tuning in. I look forward to continuing the conversation down below, and you can check out some other episodes right now.